Good afternoon, well, late morning, everybody. It's me. I'm here. I'm at the church. I know the weather isn't that great out there. You know, that's three times in a row now. Last Wednesday when I drove down, the roads were icy. We obviously didn't have church on Sunday and here today, but here I am. So social media is just so powerful. I thought, you know what? I'm going to utilize it. I'm not going to be here all that often. So every Wednesday, I'm going to make a video and post it on the social media page for the church to just let people know that I'm here, if there's somewhere that I should be. If there's somebody that you know that needs prayer, let me know, please, either on comments on this feed or through some other form, my phone number, my personal Facebook page, whatever way, let me know the prayer requests of the community. If there's somebody that's free for lunch, anything, guys, just let me know. I'm here for you, and I'm going to continue, like I said, just to make a short video weekly, and like last week when church was canceled, maybe a longer one on those Sundays, because I think it's important to come together as often as we can. So today's verse that I wanted to share was from Psalm 37:4. It is, "Take delight in the Lord, and He will establish the desires of your heart." Look, what that verse means is that it's not about us. It's not about our desires. But if we truly rely on the Lord, He will establish our plans. And those plans will be something that we never even thought was possible or something that we didn't even fathom on our own. Take delight in the Lord, and He will establish your plans. Another one that I found interesting as I was reading this morning and listening to some stuff on the way down here is the reminder that nothing in this world can satisfy us. We can try, and we often do. I know that I have before. I do on a regular basis think that we're going to get some sort of satisfaction in worldly things. Well, 1 John 2:15 says, nothing of this world can satisfy us. Only Him. Only Him. Also this, if we're not in the Word, how can we expect to grow? Take 3 minutes, 5 minutes. We all live busy lives. We all have that time. If we can make the time to do some of the other things that we're doing in our life, we can make a few minutes to read the Word. There's a quote. Oh, there it is. I've got a few notes. I don't have all this memorized. It says, win today's battle with today's preparation. Win today's battle with today's preparation. I also think about Jesus in Matthew when he says, today will have enough worries on its own. We don't need to be worrying about tomorrow, for that will take care of itself when the time comes. So we prepare for today's battle with today's preparation, because today's worries will be enough that we don't need to worry about the things of the future. And one last thing I just wanted to share with you this morning. Experiencing God in our lives is kind of like when we take a picture on social media and we look at that picture, or a picture on our phones or whatever, or share one on social media is what I meant, and like, that picture just doesn't really do it justice. Well, hearing somebody else's experience may lead us to want to follow God more intimately in our own life, but just hearing it doesn't really do it justice. We need to go to the mountain and experience God's love for ourselves. As Jesus says in the end of John's Gospel in chapter 1, He invites us, come and see. Come and see the love of the Lord your God. In all things, we glorify God. In Jesus' name, we lift up everybody in the community that has prayer needs, both spoken and unspoken today. Let me know if you know somewhere that I should be or have something in the future for me. Again, I plan on sharing these videos every week, maybe live, maybe not live, some way, shape, or form, just to form a little bit more of a community connection. And I hope everybody has a blessed day today. We'll talk to you again soon. Peace.